I'm going to invite to the floor Professor Lazaridis and Professor Magnos. Are they connected to our stream? Fantastic. What an amazing event this has been. If I may say so, this has been a big event. We are talking about 6 months of preparation, 2 days of presentations, 27 hours of streaming with minimum breaks, 85 speakers from a dozen countries at least, and 150 participants, all this due to your fantastic work. The important question is, what have we learned from this conference and where will it get us for the future?
I think one thing is certain, that we have to do it again. And I think that's the main outcome of this conference, Thanos. We did start this in a very modest and reluctant way because we're not sure how many people will react in our call for specifically food waste, because it's different to say organic waste and it's different to really focus on the food waste. So at the beginning, I think we are worried that people will not respond to our call, but the things we get now, the feedback we get now, it's very positive. We see all kinds of sorts of technology, all kinds of soft and hard technology. Katia is far more an expert than me in all these policy things, and I think she can express the same feeling. But what I see is that we cover a big spectrum of the food waste issue, from all kinds of things, from packaging to high technology and whatever else you can imagine. And I think what really comes in my mind is the fact that we need to do this again. I think if we manage to do it in a couple of years in real and physical presence of the people, it will be an enjoyable event. And that's my main conclusion, if you want my opinion. Now, before I give the floor to Katia, I just would like to thank my team, and especially Yannis Zaliakopoulos, who was behind the whole conference. It's an excellent issue to have very good cooperators and people to work with you, because you look good and you do minimum things. So I'm the lucky person. I'm exactly that. I did the minimum thing. And Yannis did all the hard work without actually ever appearing in the screen, which is excellent for my point of view, at least. So that's all for me. Thank you all for participating. A great thank you again to the final speakers, both Yigal and Christina from the two rooms. It's always hard to be the last speaker in a conference, and I think they did excellent work to close up the conference. Katia, the floor is yours.
Well, I can't say much after Thrasivoulos. It's always difficult. I would like to thank everybody on the organizing committee, the people in Symbraxis, of course, that made this event technically perfect, and also again my group that helped me a lot in this organization, but even more the group of Thrasivoulos, who helped even more. Yannis took all this event on his shoulders and did excellent work, and we thank him. And I would also like to thank Thrasivoulos, because he was the optimist. As I said, he's the optimistic person. He believed that this can be a nice conference. I thought, well, a tiny little workshop for the projects, who can organize a conference, it's COVID days. Well, it was, I'm really happy for what happened. I'm happy for what we heard. I'm really, really happy for the response of all those of you, all the speakers, all those people who came to attend, all those people who came to speak. And we had, I can talk more about the prevention aspects. And we had really world-class presentations from people who are at the forefront of research and policy and implementation. And I'm really happy for that. That demonstrates, to my opinion, the huge dynamic of the issues of food waste, both in terms of prevention and in terms of valorization, which, when we talk about high-value materials, is also a kind of prevention. So, yeah, I would be happy. And I hope we will have a nice appointment in 2 years' time. It's not fixed yet, but that's, I think, something we have to do. We can, and we will work for it. And by that time, we have difficult questions to sort out, whether it be Crete or Athens. But I hope that this will be the discussion and not which platform we use. So thanks again to everybody, each one, and all of you. Thanks. Really, really thanks. And I'm happy for the results we had.
Right. Thomas, thank you very much. Simbraxis did their best. It was excellent work, really professional, to the point. I was not expecting, I knew you could do this, but I was not expecting such a high quality result overall, to be quite honest with you. It's not just you and your team. I was not sure that this is going to be a success, because I'm really not really good feeling very well with all these teleconference things. But really excellent work, guys. Thank you very much for that.
We appreciate that very much. But before we hang up, may I ask Professor Lazaridis to start with about the one key technology of practice that you consider very important for the future of food waste management? What is the one single thing you think we should do to fast minimize this amazing waste of food in our planet at the moment?
Well, I think the basic message I'm going to take from this conference is start from the beginning, which is measure, measure, measure. We need a good baseline of the amount of food that is lost in agriculture and wasted in the further stages, so that we know exactly what we have to manage, and we have a benchmark against which we can measure our progress. So I will not speak about technologies, I will speak about the first step. We have to know the number. We saw lots of numbers. There are numbers we all repeat, but the basis of measurement is still fairly thin because it's a huge task to measure it. So yeah, good and solid and robust baseline on which we can build up our KPIs and see what we manage and what we achieve.
This is amazing, because it really shocking the numbers that we heard, the millions of tons that we heard about are really shocking, and they make you really consider what we are doing so wrong in the planet. Professor Magnos, can I please pose the same question? What do you consider is the single task, the single thing that we can do to change the course of food waste in our planet at the moment?
Well, I'm coming from the other point. As I said, Katia is excellent in prevention and policy and things like that. She knows those things very well. I'm just a student in front of her on those issues. So I'm always listening with my ears open when she speaks about those things. But we are working with technology. We are not in the prevention. We are mostly working with what happens if you cannot reduce, or whatever you produce, even after reduction, what are you going to do with it? My opinion is right now, Thanos, and I think that's a global issue, is that all these new technologies cannot reduce the cost of food waste or solid waste management. And we should never, ever express an opinion that saying, look, we have this magical technology and we can take the cost down 10 or 20 or 30 euros. That's the wrong attitude. We have to all understand that, especially in the Western economy and in the developed world, that managing our waste in a proper manner costs. So yes, we will have a better technology. Yes, it will be part of what we call the circular economy. It will produce a new line of products or a new raw material, but it will not cost less than what actually costs now. It will probably cost more. And we have to understand that. And we have to make the politicians, and most of all, the people who vote for those politicians, to understand that this is not going to be a cheap way. It will be a better way, but not a cheap way. So this is my opinion. And I think everybody who presents all these magnificent technologies, they will tell you at the end of the day that they need to be funded as a waste management facility, and then they will produce a high added value product, which, yes, it will make an added value, but it will have an added value environmentally and not economically, with a very narrow-minded approach. That's, I think, is a main issue, and that's where we need to battle in the next couple of years in order to make circular economy really a working tool.
Professor Lazaridis, if I can make one more question, what would be your advice to the tourism industry, so critical for our country, but for the entire planet as well, where the waste is unimaginable, including the island of Crete, where Professor Magnos is situated? What is the one thing that the tourism industry can change in a fast pace to reduce this indescribable waste of food?
Well, embrace the good practices that already exist in order to reduce waste, both at the kitchen and while serving. It depends also which customers they work with. If you work with European or Northern American customers, it's much easier, because they want to see prevention. They're educated that food waste is a bad thing, and they are willing to accept changes. Actually, they will be happy to be in an establishment that adopts measures. It might be more difficult with different clientels from countries where the awareness on food waste is not so high yet. But there are tools, there are also technology tools and management skills in the kitchen. And the message is that if they invest on that, which investment is mainly knowledge and to a lesser extent equipment, but knowledge and practices, they can profit from that, especially if they work with the kind of clients I told you before, because they can promote it in their sustainability efficiency. And there will be, I believe, many actions in Greece as well to promote best utilization of food in hotel establishments in the very near future. So greening their facilities and promoting that as through their greening, through awards and labels, that would help them. So that would be a win-win situation because they will save cost, obviously help the environment, and promote their image. So it's the image is a key factor in their effort to do waste management. And also we wait the new law from the Ministry of Environment, which we hope from what we know till now, but we have to see it first, that it will change the charging regime, and therefore they will not be charged just on the basis of their square meters, but on the basis of the material they produce, the waste they produce, which would create more profits from waste prevention actions. But we still wait for that.
This is was actually my next question before we come back to that, and I promise it's the last question, the third and final one. I'll give the floor to Professor Manios for the same question. You live in a tourist city, huge five-star hotels. What is your advice to the tourism industry about food reduction?
Well, it's a very difficult issue to tackle, Thanos. I have to be quite honest with you, because the main fact when you go to vacation is that you're doing things different than you do it back home. So you have a person who is very careful back home and separates and things like that, and does that for 350 days a year, and then for 2 weeks per year, I think he just gets relaxed and loose and something like that. And these hotels do help. I agree with Katia, though. It's a stage where it's what you bring from your home. It's what you bring, the culture you have in your own country. When you travel, you bring the culture with you. So if we are all trained to do this prevention, or we all accepting prevention measures back home, we will be able to do that as a tourist. So it's something that starts back home and irrelevant what you do in the country you visit. But if you want my sustainable approach, is mostly use local products in your food production process. That reduces all the carbon and things like that, and increases the local economy, and provides a sustainability with the overall approach, not a really strict how much of kilograms or grams of waste that I produce today. The overall approach is that what makes it more sustainable, and of course, the proper management after all these things is finished. So yeah, as a conclusion, use local, think global. That's what it is all about, isn't it?
And actually, you have an agency in Heraklion, Local Food Experts, I believe, which promotes exactly this, to use local produce. And I also consider this tremendously important. So now we'll proceed to my last question, and I promise that was it. I will not take more of your time, of your precious time, and it is an honor to be with you today. As a sustainability professional, Professor Lazaridis, awaiting the new legislation for food for recycling and charges based on the amount that are supposed to arrive to the to reach non-recycling facilities. What is your advice to our politicians on a national and a local level about what they can change to tackle in a faster pace food waste at this given moment?
Well, that is a difficult question. Well,
that's a conference by itself.
That's a conference by itself. You need an action plan for everything. But saying just a few, I think generally for waste management, landfill tax is the best thing you can do. Make landfill expensive so that other options become more
viable.
Become viable. So yeah, it is not just about food waste, it's about everything. I believe that a high landfill tax will help a lot the waste management in Greece. It is there are many cases from all over the world that demonstrate that. It's not going to be nice, it's what Professor Manios said, it's going to be more expensive. But it's going to also to be more sustainable. It is cheaper on the very long term in the sense that you save your resources. And then donation has a lot of possibilities, and we have to have frameworks for helping donation and removing barriers. We have to leave it voluntary, but give very specific, clear guidance and relieve barriers so that because a part of the of food that could be saved is not because of limits about safety and liability. We have to find smart ways to change that.
I understand. Professor Manios, what is your opinion on this?
Well, we have to be brave, and that's including also the political personnel of every country. So they have to be brave and they have to be innovative and think out of the box. I think the major problem we have in the country, and I think it's probably a problem globally, is that we try to reduce the cost of the service we provide regarding food, regarding waste, in order to be able to be an affordable tool for everyone. Where we should take the cost in the real scale and provide support to the ones who cannot cover it by themselves. So he has to be brave, he has to be out of the box, he has to be realistic, and he has to be innovative. We do not need all the large and huge units to do the treatment of the waste or whatever else that is out there. We need to have innovative measures, different one, to provide abilities to small, medium enterprise to actually create tools and create new technology and create new jobs. And we have to do that. And that's the only way to do that is political, right? So we have to be exactly on that stage. We have to understand that solving the problem with massive industrial units, it's only part of the solution and not the solution itself. So I think we should be open. We should be open to all kinds of sorts of technologies and solutions. And I think we did present the past 2 days a large variety of these technology and solutions. And we should allow those people, we should allow those technologies some space to develop. And they need also the funds, which comes together with the waste management issue. So yeah, bravery and innovation.
Professor Lazaridi, Professor Manios, thank you for the amazing work organizing this conference. I also have to thank Yanis Daliakopoulos, without whom nothing would be feasible. I need to thank all our speakers, an unbelievable number, about 85 people, as I said, in two parallel sessions coordinated by two sustainability professionals. I am not a presenter by work. I'm a sustainability professional myself. So thanks to our audience, 150 people, about 50 people are still connected. No further delays. We are looking forward to your presence in our next conference in a year or two, in any form that it will be possible then. Thank you very much.
Thank you.